All right. I'd like to welcome Dan Hatch and Emily Hedrick to our discussion on UX Petitions today.
Whoa.
Let's get started with six of the reasons that you should want to participate in a UX Petition.
All right. I think one of the greatest things that we've had is that we're meeting with businesses when we go out to different places. When we went out to Seattle, we met with Disney, Pixar, and we talked about the practices that they had internally. So with Disney, nobody would even think that there's a Disney operation there. They have 1,000 people in a tower there, and they're doing UX for the interactions within the park. And so we sat and we talked with the interaction designer and talked about their processes, and the students were able to ask questions, and so super exciting opportunities to really see what's happening out in the real world. In Austin this last week.
Is this industry practices?
Oh, is this industry practices? Yes.
Okay.
Sort of.
Okay.
I think so. Well, I was jealous about you in Seattle because you went to Nintendo's headquarters of North America.
That's true.
And that was pretty cool.
Okay, you're
but
jumping
that was a
the
weird
gun.
Thing.
You guys are totally jumping the gun.
Okay. I thought it was conversational.
It is, but I want to get through these six reasons.
Okay, so industry practices. So in Austin, we sat down and we did a whiteboarding.
Okay, even that's not what I want, because we're going to have a slide on Austin.
Okay.
Eventually.
Oh.
We're going to have a slide on every expedition that you guys have participated.
Well, I think
in.
That we need to maybe. Write up even more than just industry practices. It's like, what are we talking about?
I just want one sentence.
Oh.
One sentence.
One sentence on these first six. One sentence.
Oh, I thought we were gonna...
Industry practices. We do UX Petitions because it allows us to see people working in the industry. Boom. Next.
Okay.
Which one of you is going to say that?
Yeah.
Okay. Start it off. UX Petitions.
Well, okay.
So
I'm going to jump back and just say. I think that I'm not a mic, so I'm not so good at this ad-lib stuff. I've got to have
it
all planned out.
Yeah, me too.
So so I feel like we have to have a you know, better than just saying industry practices, because Mike can riff off things and, you know.
Well, but then he'll give you that much.
I know.
Then he gives us that much. I'm a kind of guy that's like slide information about that slide.
Yes.
So that it's,
yes.
You know, it's like if we're going to have it, I would like to write out all of the, what are we going to say in these different areas?
Uh-huh. Right.
So,
and that needs to happen.
Yeah.
But for now, I just want you to give me a one-liner.
Do a punchy one-liner on industry.
Jeez, punchy one-liner. Industry practice. Well, we're going around to industry partners, and we're actually seeing how they practice their craft.
Perfect.
And you work with them, too.
And we work with them. We actually worked on their project.
Okay.
Yeah. Networking. I mean, it's all about seeing their environment, but it's also understanding what their jobs and their roles and responsibilities and interfacing with it. And so students have the opportunity to work with them after the UX Petition.
Perfect. Next.
We make connections with lots of industry partners. We're going directly to those offices so that they are meeting the people who work there.
Perfect. And?
Oh, the cultural experiences. I mean, it's getting beyond just our Wasatch Front thinking. We're meeting with people in their space, and they come from all sorts of backgrounds. And so it's not just domestic, it's international.
I like that. Thank you.
Ooh, I'll take this one. Technology integration. This is what I love.
I know, you wrote this one. So.
It's the hands-on learning. It's using the software and the hardware and getting out there and doing it in that element.
Okay.
They have fun because we're fun. And we interact with them. I mean, I love interacting with the students. It's amazing. And we do fun things. And, you know, it's like running around at that conference with different groups of people. And, you know, we went and saw the Batman mobile. And we went and saw the Pixar. They had the 20th anniversary of Sally, the Pixar car, and the model that they built. And they had two guys from Pixar that came and spoke about it. It was just like, so cool.
Good. So, since 19XX, 2000 whatever, we have been on 10 different expeditions. Let's take a look at each one of them and see what some of the fun things are.
This one's all you.
Whoa. Yeah, this one was a coup. We went to, you forgot, Amazon. this is the picture of Amazon right there.
Right.
So we went, we dropped in Sunday afternoon. We had brunch with a lead Facebook or WhatsApp developer. And then the next day we were at Amazon at their headquarters. They took us through their Amazon Go store. They basically bought us lunch, took us to the 40th floor or whatever it was. Probably wasn't 40th, but it was like 20 up there. And we spent an hour basically going back and forth with the voice experience design team that was there. So, I mean, we had linguists, we had designers, we had visual designers, and developers and product managers. And crazy enough, we talked about the Go store because one of them was a designer for the Go store. But then we talked about voice experience design. And then at the end of this experience, they took us through the Amazon spheres that were down at the bottom of the courtyard there. And then, you know, we just had bang, 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 one experience after another. We had lunch with developers from the HoloLens experience team, and we talked about what their experiences were and how they were using the HoloLens already. You know, bleeding technology that you're just like, well, I don't know how you'd use it, but I mean, it was so enlightening because up to that point I just poo-pooed the whole VR stuff, and then we went to the campus, the Microsoft campus, and we had the experience using the actual HoloLenses and things like that. We went to Nintendo, which Emily was supposed to be there for that, but we went anyways. And of course, it was based on UX lead UX designer there in their offices, and they showed us how they were using UX in regards to marketing, more of the marketing side of things, not necessarily creating games or anything like that, but the marketing of the product throughout the U.S. And then we had Disney, should have been on there. Disney and Pixar. Pixar was just we went to the Disney office and they said, oh, you know, there's a Pixar office here too? Why don't you go over and see them? And after we had our Disney thing, we walked over and we went and talked to some lead developers over there at Pixar, and they gave us all the swag, and it was just like, we're like, holy crap. So it's like these opportunities to be in the environment and to actually, interact, and there's kind of this, they want students, they want this new blood, they're really excited about it. So,
how many days was this trip?
Geez, I think this was a 4-day trip.
And what did it cost the students?
It cost them $400 or $500, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, pretty amazing.
Sounds amazing. Okay, we also have a trip to San Francisco. Emily, take it away.
Mike did that one. And he rubbed it in because I was not working here yet. But that was when they got the doors open and they went to Facebook. They even went to Apple.
Yeah, they went to Apple.
Store, met with some of them. Went to Microsoft. So they're in Silicon Valley, right? You think of the tech sector and it's them, but. And that's where the giants are located, and that's where they got a glimpse of UX design and everything. But that was not my trip, and I was very jealous. I want to go back.
Okay. So who got to go to Orlando, Florida?
That was Seth.
Oh, no, he went to Huntsville.
Oh, right.
Yeah, no one has gone to Orlando yet.
Okay.
All right.
Sorry.
No, I just made this stuff up. I didn't know anybody went to San Francisco. Right.
So
it surprised me.
That was the first one.
I know. Anyway.
It was before I got hired.
Well, do you have New York on that list?
I don't. This is all I have.
No, New York is me.
Because nobody gave me any information. So my slide deck ends with three.
Can I talk about
Well,
we're doing a prototype
here. This is fine for what we want.